Hi everyone, and welcome to another Film Impact video tutorial. I'm Jaap Boerhoff. I'm the founder and senior developer of Film Impact Premium Tools, here to show you Motion Tween. And Motion Tween, ladies and gentlemen, is one of the mostly time-saving tools you've ever seen. And so what does it do, right? It takes care of movements. Have you ever seen a logo that you needed to move a little bit to the left, and you work with keyframes and everything to make it work? Those times are history. And let me show you how, because here, let's work with our own logo, right? So I'm gonna command drag, it's alt drag duplicate. And here I've got a beautiful logo, just happened to be ours. Reset all its parameters, so it's sitting there, beautiful, nicely centered. And I've worked for brands that wanted to show off their logo first. I don't know why, but they would just reveal their logo, and then they wanted to have the element being here, being as a kind of a watermark, being always present on the entire video. So you would work with that, and normally, you would use keyframes for that, but here's how things are done using Motion Tween. So I have the clip here, the logo element. I'm just making a cut. So cut. So I've got two sides here, and so the right side, I'm gonna reposition this. So I'm gonna lower the scaling, and I'm gonna set it around here. So that's good. Maybe a little bit more off the side of the edges here. So that'll work beautiful. So we've got the start, and maybe you have some kind of reveal there. Maybe you did a that's what I like, like a transform, like stretch wipe or something, you know, to reveal the element. So very cool reveal here. But now we want to move things, right? So from here to here, and this is where Motion Tween comes into play. So move, search for Motion Tween, and you'll find it in the Film Impact Smart Tools. Just drag, drop. And I'm gonna stretch out everything. So we've got position here, position there. There, playback. There's it, magically moved. It took care of the position from here to there. And why not change the resolution to half so we can have real-time playback? Oh yeah, that's good. That's looking good, right? So this is Motion Tween, and this is not the only thing Motion Tween can do, because if we dive into the parameter controls, you'll see that beautiful curve sitting there. And what if you would change the bezier to, say, an overshoot, and see how that works? So it's doing the overshoot. See how that dynamically bounces? And we can do more. I mean, we could add rotations. Why not add a Y-axis rotation? See how that works. So there you go. Oh, beautiful. See how that dynamically moves. And why not make it like a swirl? Give it a swirl. Give it a movement. Okay, this, move it to the right during the transition. So there you go. So there you go. See how that all works dynamically and beautifully, all with the beautiful dynamic bouncy curve. So this is how Motion Tween works. And you know, this animation needs more time. See how that works? Oh yeah. I mean, it might even need more time, right? I might be zoomed in too much there. So this is beautiful, right? And let's change it back. I mean, when the video is over, they want to have the logo all the way centered out. So I'm making another cut, and what I'm gonna do, I could, you know, copy the motion from position here. Just copy and select the clip and do a paste. See how that you can just copy paste, and why not copy and paste the video transition too? So I mean, this is good, right? So there you go, beautiful. Beautiful. Going back. So start, back, and there you go. And then You know what the most amazing thing is? That if you have a client that says, well, all good and well, you know, they've agreed to the entire video you've made, but they just said, well, we want to have the logo to the upper right corner. And you're like, oh, I'm here with all the keyframes, right? What do I do? Well, motion tween, let's reposition this element to the upper right side or even lower right side. And see how motion tween follows. It just follows the transition and follows it back. So this will save so much of your time. And see how much the 3D motion blur, let's set it to full res and say high quality. It's already set to high quality playback. And see how that beautiful dynamic motion blur, it really emphasizes the movement. So here we've got the rotations. Let's do a rotational Z axis rotation. See how that motion blur works with that. That's amazing. And see, there you go. And it's beautiful and it's playful. I mean, this is the way you want to work, right? And this will save you a round trip to After Effects. This will save you time working with keyframes. This will save you time doing After Effects scripting for whoever knows how that works. I mean, that you have to be a mathematician, whatever the word, you know it. You need to be really, really clever and know what you're doing. And this is all visually inside your favorite video editing app. And hope you like this. Hope you enjoyed this video. See you next time. Bye.